Hi guys, welcome to Journey with Char. How are you guys doing? It has been a while. I'm gonna get better at this. I'm waiting for my point and shoot actually, because I don't want to sit all the time when I'm talking to you guys with my little backsplash here that I have so colorful here. I saw this at the 99 cent store the other day and I just said, you know what, I just need something, because all my stuff is boxed up, all my pretties. So I said, you know what, I gotta put something so my backsplash can at least look decent for you guys. So I hope you like the little garland. It has butterflies on it. And these are candles. I got these years ago from, I don't know, it's QVC. And I think her name is Valerie Parhill. And these are like cupcake candles. And I don't even think she sells them anymore. I haven't never even burned them. You guys, I have had these over 10 years. And I saw them in storage the other day when I was boxing up stuff. And then you know how you want to throw away things you don't need anymore. And I was like, oh my God, I forgot I had these. So anyway, I don't know. I'm going to look and see if I can find if she still sells these. For you who are interested, you guys, this smells just like blueberries. It is the cutest thing ever. Let me show you this one since I'm showing you my little backsplash. And this one is just like a little cake scent. It's like a soft cake scent. But after you use these, actually you can bake in these, but I wouldn't do that. I'm using them strictly for just make your environment cute. This is like a mint, and the scent is still here. I swear, I bought this over 10 years ago. The scent are still there. Y'all, it's so hot. If you look, you can see a little glistening, and it's like sweating. The candle is literally sweating. But I mean, I don't know what kind of candle she used, because they still smell good. And this one, of course, has an apple scent, and it smells really, really good. So that's my little backsplash for you guys. And let me show you the little bird's nest that I got too. I said that's cute, so I'll just put something back there just for you guys. It could be a little colorful in my background. Anyway, so I got those from the 99 cent store, not these. Valerie Parhill QVC. I'm gonna check to see if I can find these, you guys. I did get them over 10 years ago, and I doubt that. This I got from the 99 cent store. And while I was in there, you guys, I'm soaking my feet. Yes, they're not that bad, but just to get ready for the summer, and it's good to soak your feet in vinegar. So I get these from the 99 cent store also, and I use, like, you can mix this, well actually it's the peroxide you mix with baking soda, and it does a paste. You can put that on top of your toes just to kill any discoloration you may not like, you know, sometimes a little yellow. And then also soaking your feet in this, in the white vinegar, and I believe you can do this with Listerine and with peroxide also added. You guys, if you go to Pinterest, you look up anything that's just like getting your feet ready for the summer, all kinds of different recipes and different things pop up for you to get your feet ready, because summer is coming up, and who wants their heels to be all rusty? Even though mine don't look like that, but you know, through the winter and stuff, we keep our feet covered. So we want to just get them nice and soft and ready for the summer. So this vinegar is really, really good to soak your feet in. So I'm using this. I bought maybe about 3 of these from the 99 cent store. And you guys, I saw this. I said, these are just too cute. I bought these from the 99 cent store. I was like, how cute is that? Like, please, all my other ones are put up in storage. So I was like, this is cute, honey. 99 cents and they're cute. Right, and they match my lipstick. You guys, you see my orange lipstick? I am one, I've always loved colors. Like, I'm bold with my lipstick. I won't do the purple, and I won't do the blue, and I won't do the black, however. But I've always loved gold, and I always loved oranges and peaches. And the other day, they sent a coupon from HSN in my email for $10 off. So I was like, let me find something, $10 off. So I found this lip gloss by J. Manuel. And if you guys don't know who J. Manuel is, he used to be on the Tyra Banks, you know, that model show she did? And she had the two guys. He's the one, I think he was the Puerto Rican one. Don't get me wrong. I think he was Spanish. He's the one that looks Spanish. But anyway, cute guy, really pretty teeth. This is him, J. Manuel. And he has his own line of makeup. So I saw this, it was $20, and then I did the $10 off coupon, and I was like, hey, let me try it. So it came in today. I love the orange. I really do love the orange. Orange is one of my favorite colors. The lip gloss is pretty good. It's not sticky, as you can see. I'm gonna put a little bit on just so you can see. However, remember the, it's not a brush or like, what do you call this? You know what I'm talking about, the tip. It's silicone. It's not like a brush. Let me see if I can get it. It's like silicone. See how it's not sticky? If you guys can see that. It's not sticky, but it's silicone. See, let me take it off. It's like just a slab of silicone. And you can actually see the translucent if I put it up real close. I'm trying to get all the product off of here so you can see what I'm talking about. But if you can see there, it's like you can see that little bit right there. And that right there, I saw them do it on the HSN channel. And I was like, interesting. It's something to get used to, because when you apply it, it can be messy. So you have to watch it, because it's not like where it's a sponge and it soaks it up and you can really get in there really, really good. It can be messy, and sometimes it can apply too much of the product and it can get like down here. So you have to be very careful so you're not wasting your product. So that's one thing I can say that I don't like about the lip gloss. However, the color is really pretty. You don't have to do too many applications on your lip, just like put too many layers for you to get the orange, but it's really, really nice. So that's the color I got. That's by J. Manuel. I got it from HSN, and this color is called, let me see. You guys, you know what? I don't know right offhand. I'm going to, if you're prisoner. So HSN, Prisoner, J. Manuel, you guys. So I got that today, and this is the way the package looked. So I was really excited about that. Another thing that I got the other day, and I'm going into what I got, you guys, because I haven't done a haul. This is so messy, you guys. I had my hands all over this mirror. But anyway, I bought this mirror from, where did I get this from? TJ Maxx. You guys, look, I wear glasses. And once I take these off like this, and I'm looking in the mirror and trying to apply my eyeliner, it's not happening. My eyeliner, actually, I'm shocked that I've done decent without like the eye being able to see it. I'm going to get me some contacts. I've never worn contacts before, so that's something I'm a little nervous about. However, I'm going to get me another pair of glasses too, because it's been a year and a half. So I would like to go like a year and a half to every 2 years to change up my prescription. And so I'm going to see where my eyes are at, but I'm also going to get some contacts, because sometimes you just want to be free from something being on your face all the time. And when you're putting on your makeup, which is something I am trying to learn, because so many of you guys have so many tricks and tricks. I love YouTube for that, that I'm able to learn. I've even seen some of you who I now follow put on your makeup, and I am inspired to say, you know what? I've always been good with the eyeliner, but I have never worn foundation. Never have I ever worn foundation, you guys. So this is something new to me. I went the other day, and there was a young lady that I knew, and she said, I'm going to get you a sample because I want you to try some foundation. I was like, okay, cool. She went and brought me a sample, you guys, and she got it. I believe it was from Ulta. And let me show you what the sample looks like. It's that little sample. And I believe, I don't know if you can see that, it's called Hello Flawless Oxygen Wow by Benefit. Okay, the little tag came off. I don't know what color this is. The little tag that comes in, okay, wait, I think I see it right here. Hold on, let me see what color this is. Amber. So it's the color Amber. And you guys, she looked like she got it like real close to my, like I'm not afraid to put it on right now, just so you guys can just see. And you let me know, because I don't know much about makeup. I'm gonna put a little bit of this on my face so you can see. I'm gonna try to cover up. Hold on, I don't want this all to spill out. Maybe I should have got a Q-tip, because I got a couple little spots right there. I'm not gonna put it way up on my face, because this is not, but when I do try it, I am gonna do that so you guys can see. Okay, so this is it before I smear it in. I hope you can see that. And then I'm just gonna rub it in. I know it's supposed to be this line here, and I don't know if I told you guys, I ate some eggs. I'm allergic to eggs. Somebody gave me something the other day and it had egg in it. And I did not know, and I ate it, and you guys, it broke me out. So these little marks that you see here, that's my skin. It was worse. It is clearing up. Thank you, Jesus. But it's clearing up. But I'm allergic to eggs, and that's funny because that just started. But you know, when you get older, you change. So anyway, so this is, so that's it right there, as you can see. And then I'm going to rub it in. And you guys comment below, those of you who are good with makeup, please. Comment below and let me know, girl, that is it. She hit it on the dot or mm-mm. So that's it right there. I rubbed it in right there. I don't know if I should put a little bit more so you can see. I don't have a Q-tip. I don't know why. I just happened to see this right here, and I said, let me try that so they can see. Okay. It's not covering this because I didn't put so much. But do you see how it's blending? Okay. So let me know if you think that this color matches. I think she did pretty good, but however, I'm not, like I said, this is my first time ever trying any foundation. I've never worn foundation ever before, so I'm excited about that. I don't know if that's a primer or foundation. I don't know what that is, but anyway, I'm excited about that. So back to the mirror. I bought the mirror because I can't see. You guys, when I took this off, my glasses, and flip this over, you see how that is right there? Flip that over. I was able to put this on without my glasses, and I was so happy. I said, till I go and get my contacts, at least I'm able to put on my eye makeup and my being able to see. So thank you, Jesus, for that. God is so good. He led me direct. He was like, girl, let me lead you to the mirrors because you need a mirror until you go get your eyes checked. But he takes care of me. Anyway, so you guys, that was the little 99 cent store haul. So I got these. I got this mirror from TJ Maxx, and it was $9.99 from TJ Maxx. You guys, really good little mirror. And also, I want to show you another item that I got. I don't know if you guys know the Pioneer Woman. I love the cooking channel. Oh, let me show you one more item before I even go into the Pioneer Woman thing. Let me go into this. Whenever I was a little girl, I loved crystal. My grandmother used to have crystal all around the house. Sometimes people can have too much crystal and it's just not cute, but sometimes crystal really works on your table. And it just, glass is just, it's just really pretty to me. Not too much, but just a nice touch of glass and crystal. So anyway, you guys, I saw this at the 99 cent store for $1.99. You think I didn't get it? That is so cute. Put the prettiest flowers in that. Call it a day. You can put it on a side table, middle of a table, your closet, and your little island in your closet, whatever you have on your desk in your kitchen. Just some fresh flowers in this pretty little vase. You guys, tell me that is not cute. 99 cent store, okay? 99 cent store. But I got this one. I'm not gonna tell you it was 99 cents because it wasn't. This one was $1.99. Still a good deal, okay? So I got that vase from the 99 cent store. Now, let's go back to, I love, 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 love the cooking channel. Lot of favorite cooks on there. But one of my favorites, one who has become one of my favorites is the Pioneer Woman, you guys. Ree Drummond is the bomb. I love her recipes. But not only that, I love her style. She's very eclectic, very, she's just fashionable. Not like, oh, like runway fashionable. But I like her eclectic style. I like the way her jewelry, she has her own line of jewelry. She has her own line of cute little eclectic shirts that's very comfortable and breezy. And I love, 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 love her kitchen. You guys, she has a kitchen that she goes to on her show that's not even in her house. It's a kitchen she drives to and cook. It is absolutely the most beautiful kitchen. You guys got to check it out. And when you watch her show, if you've never seen her, you have got to look at her kitchen aids that she used on the show. She doesn't have plain color kitchen aids that we're accustomed to. She goes to an artist and she draws the most beautiful flowers on the outside of these kitchen aids. I think I'm going to do a link just so that you guys can see exactly what I'm talking about. You guys, absolutely beautiful. Like, they are gorgeous. But anyway, she has her own line of dishes and homeware kitchenware, I should say, at Walmart. And you guys, her Walmart stuff is so pretty. But then she also opened up this mercantile store in her hometown in Oklahoma. And you guys, the store is like in this old 100-year-old building, and they refurbished everything. And it is just all, I just love stuff like that. Just hardwood floors, and it's just really, really beautiful. Old, you know, sometimes you just want that old school stuff. You know what I'm saying? So you guys check out her mercantile store. I'll try to put a link down below so that you guys can go directly to it. The items that she sells, the store is Halfway Bakery. It's a shop, and it's like you can buy clothing. It's like a one-stop shop, and you can eat. It's a restaurant. You guys check it out. I'm telling you, it's so adorable. All of her stuff that she has for the kitchen, she even has jewelry. She sells all of that. So when you hit shop, you'll see all of her items pop up. There's some dishes I want. Oh my God, they're absolutely gorgeous. A set of 6 dishes that just has that old look to it. I'm going to be sharing that with you guys soon. But anyway, I was in the Walmart the other day doing some shopping, and I just happened to stop by the aisle where her stuff was, and I was like, oh my God, these were like the last two. They both come in a set of 4, but I was like, I don't care, I'm gonna get the set of 4. I'll just have 5 of each. You guys, look at these mugs. I can't. I mean, they're like 20, I think they're like 24 ounces. No, this is 28 ounces. Is that not like the most beautiful mug you have ever seen? Look at the handle alone, and the rope, the beautiful flowers, and just the print, the color inside and out. It's a heavy mug. I like that it has that rest there. It is just, your whole hand can fit. You can do it this way, or you can just put your whole hand in there. You guys, absolutely beautiful. And what I love about this set is that she has the dishes that match, but she also has dishes that go, you know how they layer the dishes, and not all of them, it could be one that's printed at the bottom, then a plain color, and then another plain color at the top, or a printed color in between the plain color. If you go to her website, you'll see what I'm talking about. But this, there's a set of dishes that match this, you guys, beautiful. Okay, so that's one. I could not resist that. Then there's another one. You guys, I fell in love. I was like, this is just same cup, but different print. And they also have the dishes to match this. You just like one, like I want both sets, like what? So this comes in a set of 4, or you can buy them singular. You may not want a set of 4. You may say, you know what, this is just for me. I don't have much company, you know, that come over or whatever. Maybe you want to buy 2, maybe you want to buy 1, maybe you want to buy 4, or maybe you want to buy a set of 8. It's up to you what you want. But isn't that adorable? Look at those roses. Like, how beautiful is that print? You guys, I fell in love with that, and I want you to see the handle. How pretty is that handle? Another thing that I saw, it was the last one in the shop. Where's that one with her, with the butter dish? I think it's over there. Hold on one moment, you guys. I'm sorry. I think it's in this one. So there's a butter dish. I've been looking for a butter dish because when I was growing up as a youngster, you okay, baby? As I was growing up as a youngster, my grandmother always had a butter dish in her on her table. So when I saw this butter dish, you guys, I said, okay, I gotta get the butter dish. I love the clear ones, but I also, and like I said, I love glass. How cute is that butter dish, you guys? Like, how cute is that butter dish? Like, how pretty would that be on a table for breakfast? And you have like the turquoise set out or something like that, and it's layered, and you just, they have the pitcher that match this. They also have the salt and pepper shaker that match this. But me, I'm not a real matchy-matchy girl. So I like to blend different things together and just bring it all together. So, but to each his own. If you like to match, they do have a pitcher that matches this and a cookie jar that matches this. Really, really pretty. You guys, this thing is so heavy. And I haven't really opened it yet, but it's, as you can see, it will hold huge. Because sometimes you can get butter dishes and you put the top on and the butter doesn't, you can see it come through because it's not really big enough for the stick of butter. This is big enough for the stick of butter. I bought this, I believe this one was $9. But last one, cannot find it. Looked online, people were like, oh my God, it's the hardest thing. Because it usually comes in a set. I was happy that I got it by itself because I don't want the salt and pepper. And then peach shaker. And then people weren't saying too many good things about the salt and pepper shaker. So I said, that's fine, I don't care. I just want this butter dish. But you guys, how beautiful. How this handle, you can just grab it. I love the grab of the handle, that it's not too small or too big. It's perfect size. So you guys, that's by Reed Drummond too. I'm telling you, you guys have to go check out her stuff. Absolutely adorable. Okay, so that's that, the butter dish. And then I got the two mugs. Let me put that away, because I like to put my stuff away so I don't break anything. Can you put that separate from that mug? And then I want to show you guys another thing. Okay, so I told you guys about World Market. I hope you guys, some of you guys signed up with World Market. They always send coupons in the mail, and they always let you know when they're having a sale. This weekend, I was extremely busy, but they had a sale. Well, not a sale. They gave out a coupon that they usually do every single year. It's called Friends and Family. You get a 30% off coupon that they send you in the mail. And if the item is on sale, it excludes food, though, and wine, because they sell wine and food. So it does not include the wine and the food. You will get a 10% off on the wine, I mean on the food during that time, but that's it. So anyway, to make a long story short, they sent an email, 30% off Friends and Family. And last night, I believe was the last night, I rushed there, you guys, because I was at work so late. I was calling them and like, please hold this. And so thank God that I was able to get there on time. So yesterday, when I got there, however, let me show you, because this was not what I was supposed to buy. Let me show you why I went crazy. Okay, you guys, how pretty. How pretty are these two lamp bases? Two. I said two, so let me show you two. I bought these beautiful lamp bases. Now, I used to work at World Market, and I used to see these all the time. Let me set one up just so you can see how pretty it is from behind. Yeah, just so you can see how pretty it is. I used to see this all the time, and I remember when our store was going out. It was closing because they were moving, not going out of business. And you know how you want to wait and just wait and just wait. And I would just like kind of hide it around the store so that people wouldn't see it. Somebody found it. And they got it for 90% off. I was bummed because I couldn't say, hey, that is my lamp. What are you doing? I can't do a customer like that. So anyway, just let it go. And I was just like, whatever. So I looked up online the other day and I saw these are being discontinued. So if you have a World Market and you love this lamp base, and you have a World Market in your area, you better go check it out, because this item is being discontinued. It's not coming back anymore, and it's normally $26.99. I don't know if you can see that right there, $26.99, and it went down to $13.49. If you can see that right there, it went down to $13.49. Then when I went online, it was $12.99. But I had a $10 off coupon, because when you spend $200, not at once, that it just, every time you go and put your number in, once it adds up to 200, they send you a $10 off coupon. I happen to have a $10 off coupon. So your girl was like, whoo, okay, 30% Friends and Family combined with a $10 off coupon, I can get both of these. So I went into one store, they only had one, and I saw them holding two. And I'm just like, but you know how the stores do now, where you can order it online, then you have to go pick it up. So that's what that situation was. So I ordered one, and I said, can you check another store to see if they have it? And they did. And so the other store was probably about 25 minutes, no, about 15 minutes away from me, not that long, 25. Traffic, 25 minutes. But anyway, so I got this, and while I'm like waiting for the gal to go get it for me in the back, the one that they did have left, I saw this baker, you guys. I was like, oh my God, that, I don't know what's going on with me and teal. I'm like, teal is really popping right now, but it's a color that it's not, I don't go by what's in, that's not my style, but it just really is grabbing me right now. So the teal, I love color. Color just brightens your day, and whatever you put in your kitchen, whatever your theme is or whatever your color is, it just makes you happy, right? So anyway, I saw this, you guys, how pretty, and it's heavy. Beautiful baker, look at that. And they have a lavender one. It's absolutely beautiful as well. But look at the print on that. I fell in love with this. So I got both of these items together for $11. Okay, this was $15.99, as you can see. But because I had the $10 off candle, I mean $10 off coupon, where did I get candle from? coupon and then had the 30% off for friends and family, I was able to get both of these items for $11, you guys. I was just ecstatic. So I hope you like, I just fell in love with this because of the gold leaf look. And I just think like a really pretty, there I go again, like a light, I mean, you have to just, I'm gonna try to find a top to really bring this gold out, because what they were offering, I didn't like it. So I'm on a hunt for a really good top. If you guys have any suggestions of what would look pretty, it can't be too much, it can't be a print because this is, it has to be a plain color top, but just an absolutely beautiful one. And this just really, you guys, I just fell in love. So what I'm gonna do, I have to get my, I haven't put the light bulb in because I want to make sure everything is working before this week is up, because if it's not, I'm returning them. But how pretty is that? I just love the leaf. I love that it's on a base, and it's just absolutely adorable. So I hope you guys love those. I'm gonna stick this one right up here behind me also as I'm talking, finishing talking to you guys, just so you can see. So that was that. Another thing that I got, I wanted to show you guys. Let me put this away so that I don't. If I can. Okay, so another two things that I got. I went the other day because I was looking for, I love like pink lipsticks, different color lipsticks. And I went the other day and I found some like glosses. Okay, so you guys, this new thing by NYX, it's called Epic Ink. Right here. I love the color. I want to show you what it looks like when it's on. I am going to take this off my lips. Can you give me a piece of paper towel, please? A piece of paper towel, please. I am going to take this off my lips. You guys, it is burning up here in California. Like, if it's too cold, we complain. Now it's too hot, we're complaining. Californians are never happy. But I do live in one of the hottest areas in Southern California. And I tell you, it is hot tonight. Like, you can feel summer coming. And I'm just like, oh my gosh, it's just too much. But anyway, we're getting rain again. Like I said, I enjoy the rain. We're getting rain again Monday and Tuesday. So I can't wait for that. But anyway, I'm going to take this orange off because I want you guys to see. First, I'm going to show one color. Okay. So I'm taking that orange off. Taking it out. Okay, so I took this off. And I'm not going to put the ink one on yet because it does not come off. So let me put this one on. This is by NYX too. The colors are very similar. I wanted to see which one I liked. Thought I was going to like both of them. This one is called Monte Carlo and it's by NYX. I like this color. It's like, I believe it's called like a soft matte. And I like it. However, don't put too much on because it can get, let me show you guys how it looks. Let me put it on this so I can see, child, because it's probably all over the place. Okay. I have a sick child here. Anybody still got a lingering cough? He had a little cold, and that cough is still lingering. You guys, I try to put more than one little. Let me just go to the regular. And this is soft, like a soft matte. This is the third, as you can see on her eye. Okay. So this is the soft matte. I hope you can see it really good because I don't have the camera right up on my face. But that is the color of it right there. And it's the Monte Carlo. And I like this one because it does feel, it feels really soft. I'm going to let it kind of dry a little bit. So that you can see how it transfers. If I like kiss my hand, I can swatch it if you guys can't see it too much on my lips. Let me just swatch it and bring that color so you can see that. Okay. All right, so it's still transferring. So that's that. And that's the Monte Carlo. And so let me show you guys. So this one's fine. It comes right off. Let me show you how it comes off. Okay. Let me show you why I am returning this bad boy. Because what's beautiful about Ulta is when you don't like the item that you're using, you can return it. And so, but I wanted to show you guys because what I did not, I was like, I didn't see ink. And I just thought maybe, I didn't know what ink was. I don't know if some of you guys know what ink is. So it's like an ink, literally. It's like a pen ink. So you put this on your lips, okay? You see how shiny that is? It feels like water on. Like, okay, so let me just do this right here. Trying to get every crease. Color is popping. Love the color. Love it. Like I said, it feels like your lips are wet. It's like ink. Okay. What I did not like about this, I want to see, because some of you might be like, I like it. And I like to show things. Just because I don't like it doesn't mean you're not going to like it. So I'm still going to show you before I return the item. Okay, you guys see how pretty that? Beautiful. Love the color. I'm going to put just one more application on because I like it a little. Okay, hold on. Okay. So that's the ink. Love the color. I can feel it on my lips. It's drying. Let me see. Oh, love the color. Love the color. Matter of fact, let me tell you what color it is instead of keep telling you I love it. So this color is called, does that say more? Y'all see me? I'm telling you, it is real. The struggle is real. I don't know why they put this stuff. So what does that say at the bottom of that? Because I want to tell my beautiful viewers, what does that say? Heartbreaker. Who? Who? Tom Bior. Okay, it's called Heartbreaker. And it is by NYX. This is the problem. You see my tongue? My tongue is pink. Okay? That's the regular color of my tongue. But if you accidentally, like you talk to me just like, oh, okay, girl. You just accidentally, I'm like, I don't need this to come off on my tongue like that. That scared me because I was going, girl, I thought I had it. I was like, oh my gosh, I got a color. I'm so happy. This is wonderful. And you know, when you talk, a lot of times you don't even know your tongue is coming out. You know, you may lick. It's just a habit sometimes. And I went to the bathroom. No, I looked in the mirror. That's what I did. I looked in the mirror because, you know, you have to occasionally make sure nothing's in your nose. Make sure everything's right. You ain't got nothing in your eyes and stuff. So I'm looking in the mirror and I just happened to just, you know, I always look at my teeth. And I don't know how I did it, but what in the world? I'm thinking I'm bleeding. So I'm thinking I'm bleeding. It's this. So I said, that's teen too much. I'm not. So I'm taking this back. Color is beautiful. However, even when it's dry, what bothers me is that if you happen to act, even in your teeth, it'll start coloring your teeth. Because it's ink. It start, like your teeth start getting the color of, like you bleeding in your teeth. I don't want pink teeth. I brush my teeth. I don't have bleeding gums. But anyway, so that's going back, you guys. But to you, whoever like it, and you may say, girl, you shouldn't be licking your lips or watch the way you talk. You know, fine. To each his own. Go get it because I'm telling you, it's a beautiful color. I'm not going to beat that up. It is a beautiful cover. However, I can't deal with the tongue thing. I cannot deal with it. So, and it does not come off. Okay, so I'm scared to swallow, but let me do this right quick. Let me do it on this hand. Okay, so that's it. It does not come off. It's beautiful. Now, I did just wipe it, but that doesn't come off, so it wouldn't transfer to your water bottle, which can be embarrassing, your cup. Because sometimes I can be embarrassed. It's just like, Lord, you try to be on a budget, and you're just like, can I find a lipstick that just does not transfer? It is the hardest thing to me to find lipsticks that do not transfer. If you know of any lipsticks that do not transfer, don't clunk up. It's just, I mean, there's no perfect, but at least it's near perfect. Please let me know because I love lipstick. However, I'm looking for a really good quality lipstick. Even if it's an affordable drugstore quality lipstick. And even tell me one that may be a little bit on, but I don't mind. every blue moon, treating yourself to a nice quality lipstick. So anyway, I'm taking this one back, you guys. Absolutely beautiful color. I love it, but I have to take it back. This one, so they are similar to each other. This one's a soft matte, the Monte Carlo, and this one is, I forgot, what did you say this one was?
Heartbreaker.
Heartbreaker by NYX, you guys, and it's the ink. Okay, Heartbreaker by NYX, and it's the ink. I'm taking this back to Ulta. That's what I love, Ulta, because you can take these items back. So anyway, and the other one that I got was the J, just to let you guys know one more time. So you say, what was that? Well, you know what? I'm going to link it below for the orange one. So anyway, you guys, I hope everything has been going well. You know why I am talking to y'all? I should at least put some, I'm a lipstick person, I am. So I'm going to put some of the matte on top of that one. And I even tried both of them together, and they're very pretty together. I was thinking even I might even try doing this first and then putting the matte on, which I just did, and just seeing and keep it. But then, well, I don't know. I haven't decided yet, but I'm going to see if it transfers even with the matte on top. But I just can't do the ink with that. That's just crazy to me. But anyway, you guys, I pray everything has been going well with you guys. I have been... God has been good to me. I've been still reading my Bible. Right now I'm in Numbers, and it is absolutely a good book because it's really telling us about the obedience, listening to God, obeying Him, following His instructions. When you don't, back in the Old Testament, it shows what happened and how holy He was, and it is still today because God never changes. We change, not Him. And so that's what I'm learning. I'm asking God to deal with me with things, being patient. And also, my issue here lately has been not letting people who are mean and rude affect me to where I become mean and rude. God was letting me know, because I'm at a job, I'm at a place, it's supposed to be a Christian environment. It's a Christian university. That does not mean, I don't ever want you to think that I was like, it's a Christian universe, so everything is just going to be perfect. No. We know that even in our churches, even in our own lives, we are not perfect. So anybody to think because it's a Christian environment that it's going to be perfect, you are sadly mistaken. That's where you can see some of the worst behavior. Okay, so right now I'm at this job, and it's just amazing to me. Amazing to me how different environments can be so different. I've worked in a store, World Market. I've worked in a store. I was a cashier there at World Market. I've worked, done retail all of my life. And I've always had to do customer services. I've dealt with some crazy customers, you know, people that, you know, you never know what they're going through in life. And then some people that are just spoiled, just think life is all about me and this is what I want it now. And I've learned throughout life, God allowed me to be in that business to where I've learned how to deal with people and how to be patient and how to, when you look at somebody misbehaving and acting what you think is a fool, a lot of times God says, okay, now you see how that person's acting. Instead of judging that person because you don't know what they've gone through in their lives, what struggles they've had, what they're going through currently, look at yourself and see how do I look crazy to somebody else? So I'm learning, don't judge, don't pin, don't point fingers. Look at yourself and say, Lord, what can I change about me? So one of the things that I've encountered being at this job is that out of all my work that I've ever done, I have never been in an environment like this before in my life. These are some of the rudest people I have ever worked around in my life. And you just, at first you're just thinking, is it me? Am I like, I started thinking, am I being too sensitive? Am I fickle feelings, is that what they call it? I'm just like, what is going on? But then the Lord let me know, but look at you. I want you to look at yourself in this environment. What can you change in you? And then where I'm taking you and what God may have me doing in the future is teaching me how to treat people and love people. Even though I've always treated people nice, God always said, I'm going to take you to another level of kindness. I want you to be. I want you to be so much like me, more and more and more. So I'm going to even show you more. You guys, I have never been in an environment where you can literally talk to one person, few people, one day and they see you the next day and act like they never even talked to you before, and you're like, hey, and they're just like, and you're like, wow, really? It is just, some of these people that are in this environment have positions that are what they consider, you know, the position. And they just carry the nastiest attitude. And let me tell you guys, that doesn't mean anything to God. Your position, how you treat people, does. God does not care about if you're the president, a king, a queen, a owner of a whatever. You have to love people where they at. I don't care if they're scrubbing your floor with a toothbrush. Who are you to mistreat somebody else? Who are you not to acknowledge a person? Who do you think you are? So I have seen some of the worst behavior and have experienced some of the worst behavior towards me and seen it done towards other people. And I'm just like, wow, these people are in a bubble. And it saddens me because students are around them and you can even see the behavior transferring to the students. Instead of it teaching about love and Christ love, because it's supposed to be a Christian environment, you just see the behavior from the staff, the students. It's just in the entire university. So I'm praying for this university. My son went to this school, so he already told me a long time ago. I remember him telling me how difficult it was for the interaction, you know, with the students. A lot of times, culture, because of race, because of status, how much money they have, or how it's crazy. But that's the world today. I understand that. But I'm talking about when God puts you in a place, He places you there in the middle of all that mess. He wants you to focus on Him so that you can get the message of what He is. He training you within that environment. Those people may never change, but what does God want to change in me, in you, when He has you in a position that is so uncomfortable? You're just like, Lord, what in the world is going on? I don't understand. How did I get here? Why did you bring me here? Where I was, God is like, yeah, where you was fine. Everybody left, but I want to put you in a place where people need to see me through you. So that's something, and it's tough, y'all. It is not easy, because you see, I mean, you're walking down, you see a person you've talked to one moment, they see you walking right behind you, hear them, and then you're walking through a door and they don't even know it opened for you. I mean, they're just like, you know, and I'm just like, and I think that's another thing, courtesy, kindness, saying hello. When you see a person walking down the hallway in the opposite direction, what's wrong with looking, hi, how are you today? Hi, how are you? You know, I've asked some people, hi, how are you, fine? And it's just like, no, how about, oh, I'm doing fine, how are you today? And then, you know, people say, it's always, I've learned in our culture, we always give excuse for the bad behavior. You never know. We've all gone through trials and tribulations and hard times. But a lot of times when that person says hello, you never know, that person could have a message for you. That person can want to take the hello a little further, may help you be uplifted that day. You may be going through something. That person didn't do whatever it was that you're going through. And it's okay, a smile and hello sometimes can brighten up a person's spirit. But like I said, you know, I'm not making excuses or anything, because let me tell you guys, I was ready to quit this job. But God was like, I put you there, so you don't go anywhere until I tell you to. And I was like, okay, I'm listening. But I had to get out of myself, because it wasn't about me. It was about Him being shown in me out, that light coming out. That is what is so important. You all, we want to get so much in our feelings. We want to get so much in, honey, wait a minute. You know, I was just talking to you the other day. You know, I even caught myself one day, one woman, I mean, we had a conversation the next day. She didn't even, it was like, not the next day, but maybe like a couple of days. She acted like she didn't even know me. And I remember I saw her another day and she was like, hi. And I looked at her like she was crazy. Like, is it in the water, in the air? I don't understand. But the Lord said, now what in that represents me? I don't care. Does she pay your bills? Does she take care of you? Does she feed you? Does she give you health and strength? It does not matter. That woman does not live with you. You should have said hello. Let your light shine. But we want to be in our feelings. I wanted to be in my feelings and be like, no, I'm going to let her know, honey, you don't talk to me one day and then think you could come around the next day and say hello to me. I don't think so. But then God says, yes, I think so. I need for you to say hello and let that come. That's her problem. Let me deal with her. pray for her. Have you ever thought that I place people in front of you just so that you can pray for them? So then that's another thing I had to start learning. Pray for people. Pray for people. Y'all, I'm not perfect. I've been through a lot in my life. Every day we need correction because we are never perfect. There's never a day like Jesus. Woo, I did good today. Let me tell you, I did good today. I'm about to go to bed in a few minutes. You need to give me a star, an extra crown on my star on my crown because I did good today. No. That ain't what you do. Every day we need Jesus. Every day we are a hot mess when we wake up and he gives us life. And we say, thank you, God, for giving me breath and waking me up this morning. Every day when we're going through struggles, hardships, y'all, I went through some stuff here recently. And God was like, you're going to have to trust me. I'm like, it's just like you're on, like right on a cliff. And your foot is the last thing that's holding you from falling completely off. And you're just like, you're going to let me go this far off the cliff? Trust me. Trust me. And I identify that with how the Israelites failed. If any of you are familiar with the Bible, how the Israelites must have felt when they were running from the Egyptians and they were right there at the tip and they looking at Moses like, okay, so you done brought us out here. How are we gonna get over here? And Moses got lift that rod and they were on the tip of the cliff. That's what I'm just giving you. They weren't in the cliff, but like I was giving you an example of me being on a cliff. They were right there. And what did he do? Split that ocean open. Dry that land so they can get across. And I tell y'all, he's the same God yesterday, today, and forever. He fixed my situation and said, I told you, trust me. So I was just like, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. All three in one. Thank you. So you guys, that's why I always say, I always tell you, whatever you're going through in life, if you have never, ever, ever trusted Jesus, if you have never, ever, ever, ever picked up a Bible, you don't know who he is, heard about him, just go to him where you are and just say, I want to know who you are. If you're real, say something to me, speak to me. But then also pick up the Bible and just start reading it. Just start reading it. Just pick up a chapter or even start from Genesis just to see how those people in the past, how they had to trust God and to the end, what Jesus did for us and all of that, what it says in the end of the word about his disciples and how they went out and spread the gospel. You guys, God is real. God is real. I heard a young girl today on Facebook. It hurt my heart because she was talking about how she does not believe in Christianity, the religion of Christianity. And I said, that's the problem. Christianity is not a religion. It's a faith in Jesus Christ. I follow Jesus. Okay? Read the word on your own. Ask God to come into your heart. Find a good Bible-believing church. Trust Jesus. I'm telling you guys, he's real. He saved me. I'm telling you. I have some stories. And one day I'm going to do get to know Char a little bit more better, because I've been through a lot and I know a lot of you have been through a lot. A lot of you have gone through the same thing that I have gone through. And one day I'm going to talk about that, because if it were not for Jesus, I would not be here today saved if it were not for Jesus. So you guys, salvation is real. Jesus is real. Serving God is real. Being a Christian is real. Is it easy? No. Is it rewarding? Yes. It's hard. It's not easy. It's very difficult. But it is the most rewarding thing I could have ever done in my life. I've always been in church all throughout my life. But you know how a lot of people, I've always been a Christian. No, a lot of times our parents introduce church to us. But it's up to us when we become grown, are you living for Jesus? That's the difference. You can't love the Lord and you go into the club. You just can't do that. I'm sorry. I'm one of those people. I just don't believe that. You can ask God for forgiveness. Yes, you can. But when you live for, when Jesus says, if you love me, then you will live for me. You guys, that's dying to this flesh and drawing closer to God and letting him change you for what it is he put you on this earth to do, your purpose. Your purpose is not your job. People think, oh, my purpose is to be a lawyer. No, that's your gift. That's your craft. That is not your purpose. What is God's purpose and plan for you? What is his gift that he gave you? His spiritual gift that he gave you? These are a lot of things we have to find out. And you guys, I have to find out. It's not easy, but it's so rewarding. Pray. And prayer is the most beautiful thing that has ever been given to us, that Jesus died on the cross so that we're able to go to God and pray. Y'all, when you're going through something and you sit up there and think that you can meditate, that's not doing anything. It's going nowhere. I promise you, pray to God. In Jesus' name, just say, Lord, I need you to hear me, Jesus, please. This is what I did. This is what I did. I feel nasty. I feel dirty. I feel this way, this and that, that and this. I feel like a failure. This is what I did. Lord, I'm dirty. I just feel nasty inside. It's just no good. And Jesus says, I'm going to clean you. I'm going to pick you up. We're going to start over. I'm going to get you on the right road. But you got to listen. You got to obey me. It's not going to be easy, but I'm here. My spirit's in you. Accept me in your heart. Everything is going to be okay. Just because I said everything is going to be okay does not mean you're not going to have challenges. We have to have challenges in order to know we need God. There anybody that tells you, girl, I've never been through that. Okay, then I love to say I've been through stuff and God pulled me through. That's a testimony. That's giving him glory. So anyway, you guys, I can keep preaching. Well, not preaching, but I can keep talking and talking about the goodness of the Lord because of how much he's done for me. I am so grateful. It gives me chills whenever time I talk about him. I'm just so grateful for who he is. But anyway, I'm so happy that I was able to do this vlog tonight. I do have two more vlogs that I'm going to do. There's a Carol's Daughter vlog, a vlog that I'm going to do because I'm going to show you what I'm putting in my hair on. It should be coming in like 2 days. I'm going to show you what I've been doing with my hair. Right now it's olive oil and a little bit of conditioner. I'm going to show you which one on the hair vlog that I'm going to do. And also I did another candle haul. You guys are going to do another candle haul from Bath & Body Works. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed my vlog tonight. And if you like Journey with Char, please subscribe. Give me a thumbs up. And also I think it's like a little bell that you can hit. And every time I post something, you can it'll give you an alert. Also, you guys, if you don't see on the side, I did include my Pinterest page. I have a Pinterest page. When you guys go there, you'll see all the things. You'll get to know me even more, a little better, of things that I love, because I love decorating, cooking. I love everything. So visit my Pinterest page. You can just click the little P up in the right hand corner. And I hope you guys enjoy. Thank you for watching Journey with Char. You guys have a lovely evening. God bless. Bye bye.